minds of our youth to make them have confusion of our deen and to just, you know, let them hesitating to take the deen seriously. And the doubt says that Al-Quran Al-Kareem is talking about slavery and why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not end slavery. If the slavery is something bad, why Allah does not end it? If the slavery is something good, that why Allah talk about it, how comes that as a Muslims, you believe that there is slavery? This is the doubt. Yeah, it's hard doubt, but we have to know the ayat in Al-Quran which talking about slavery, the notions of it, maybe many of us, they don't know it. Yes, there is mentioning about slavery in Al-Quran, but how? This is inshallah my khatira today, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. There are three things in our Islam shows us that Al-Quran and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like slavery. And Al-Quran actually ends it. And I have the dalil now. Al-Quran ends slavery in indirect way. How comes? With three concepts and notions in Al-Quran Al-Azim. Notion number one, Al-Idq, to release, to free those who were slaves at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to release them, first of all, Al-Idq. The second issue, or the second notion is Al-Mann wal-Fida. Al-Fida means to release these slaves with conditions, with something. They have to do something or they have to replace, to give you exchange, to give you slaves and they take slave. Al-Mann wal-Fida. Then the last one and the last notion and the most important one, and in my view, this notion, it ends the slavery, which is mean al-mukataba. Fakatibu. We're gonna do it. Let us explain one by one. Three notions now in Al-Quran. First one, just release them. When you have something, la qaddar Allah, in that time, if you kill someone by mistake, you kill him khata. وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا خَطَأً فَتَحْرِيرُ رَقَبَةٍ مُؤْمِنًا. Go ahead. The expiation, the takfir, if you kill someone by mistake in that time, you have to release a neck in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Release it. But why? Why you have to release? If Islam loves slavery, why Allah is telling us and ordering and commanding people to release the slaves in the path of Allah? Why? If Islam loves it, it doesn't come in this way. It wouldn't come like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the believers that if someone kills someone by mistake, now we have a cordon, but in that time, release a one neck and give fidya, give money for the family of the qatil. Or if he kill him intentionally, that in that time, it should be killed also. But here there is uquba, punishment. You have to release a one neck from all these necks, from the slaves. This is the first notion in the Quran. The second notion, which al-mann wal-fida, that means any war in the time of Rasulullah ﷺ, right away, the one who wins, they take the one who got defeated as a slave, right away. It's automatically. It's like rule. It's like law there in that time. It's rule. Group A wins, group B will be right away slaves, right away. Al-Quran said, إِمَّا مَنَّا بَعْدُ وَإِمَّا فِدَاءً. Bring our slaves and take your slaves. This is the first issue. Or, فِدَاء, or مَن, just go. Some, subhanAllah, from Mushriki Mecca, Rasulullah ﷺ told them, teach our people how to read and how to write, and we will release you, we'll free you. Just teach them. Allahu Akbar. Yeah? After the war, the time of Rasulullah ﷺ, there are people that got captures, come here. You know how to teach. Okay, teach, then you will be released. Why? If Islam loves slavery, why Rasulullah ﷺ released nicks in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the second notion. The third one, and I will end my khatira, that al-mukataba. And please memorize it. Al-mukataba. What the meaning of al-mukataba? The first, actually, constitution in the history of mankind to release nicks, like with the documents. You have to write, anyone from the slaves want to be free, you should as a slave go to your master and ask for releasing, for free. Freedom. Ask, just ask. And write it, give money, go. Yeah, buy your freedom. Then Allah said after that, وآتوهم من مال الله الذي آتاكم. Even if your slaves don't have money to release themselves, you give them money and let them release themselves. In my opinion, this is the end of slavery. The Quran clearly says, فكاتبوهم إن علمتم فيهم خيرا وآتوهم من مال الله الذي آتاكم. كاتبوهم, have مكاتبة, عقد, contract. Let them buy themselves. Let them buy their freedoms. And if they don't have money, give them money. And let them release themselves. Quran, it's so clear. For now, with these three notions, actually, in my view, there is no slavery in Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not love slavery. Allah does not love slavery. Okay, there are ayat talking about that milk al-yameen, you have to be good with them. Yes, if you have milk al-yameen, you have to be good with them. It comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a command also for those who have slaves at that time. You have to be nice with your slaves. Okay. It doesn't mean that Allah loves slavery. With these three notions, there is no slavery in Islam. And Rasulullah ﷺ in the last ceremony, last khutbah, what he said? كلكم لآدم وآدم من تراب لا فرق لعربي ولا عجمي ولا لأبيض ولا لأسود ولا لأحمر إلا بالتقوى كأسنان المشط. There is no difference between the red ones, the white ones, the black ones, the Arabic ones, the non-Arabic ones. There is no difference except with the taqwa. And subhanAllah, the whole ulama of as-sunnah, the whole of them, the main books in our sunnah, in our madhab, sunnah wal-jama'ah, the six books of as-sunnah, all those who يعني, root these books from our, all of them were non-Arab. To show you, subhanAllah, the unity which we have it. Al-Bukhari, he wasn't Arabic guy. He was Ajami, but he learned Arabic, okay. But he wasn't Arabic, Al-Bukhari. Muslim, he wasn't Arabic. Abu Dawood, he wasn't Arabic. Al-Nisa'i, he wasn't Arabic. Ibn Majah, he wasn't Arabic. A lot of our ulama, في السنة والتفسير وفي الفقه, they weren't Arabic people. They were non-Arabic people, but they learned Arabic and they were ulama. This issue shows us that there is no difference between Arabic and non-Arab. There is no difference between black and white and red and brown. We don't have these differences. No slavery in Islam. قولاً واحداً. No slavery in Islam. And this is my evidence for this guy. طبعاً I told our young guy, and now we are, inshallah, يعني, shooting a video. We wanted to teach our kids and ourselves first. Do you heard before about al-mukataba? We have to know it. We have to say al-mukataba. Write your contract. Yalla. Yalla, go ahead. Buy your freedom. This is in al-Islam, in al-Quran. Katibuhum. In al-Quran, in our deen. As a first action for human beings to release and free themselves from slavery. It was in the Quran. Fakatibuhum. In alimtum fihim khayra. Wa atuhum min malillah. Even give them money to buy themselves. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to kick and remove all these doubts from our hearts. And now ala kulli shay'in qadeer. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.